What's up guys, SP Architects here. Today we are going to create dimensions on site plan and also site elevations. When we are preparing a project in ARCHICAD, we use floor plans and also we use site plans. It's easy to place plans into layout. You can just drag and drop here, or it's automatically created by ARCHICAD. But when we need to place site plan, we go to view map and use this site plan. But as you can see here, we can see all of the plans, but we cannot see the roof. As you all know, in site plan, we must see the roof of the building. First, we are going to fix that. But before we begin the tutorial, I would just like to ask you to like this tutorial. It's going to help this channel to growing up with YouTube algorithms, and I suggest you to subscribe because I'm going to create similar tutorials like this. And if you want to download this or my other project files, you can reach them in my Patreon page. With that page, you can find more interesting ARCHICAD tutorials, more libraries. Alright, without any further ado, let's get into the tutorial. Alright, here we are in ARCHICAD. And we are going to fix this site plan. I suggest you not to use this site plan. It's going to waste your time. In this case, we are going to follow another way. For that way, I'm going to use this generic axonometry. Let's click that. And here we have our axonometric view. And for this view, I just go to settings here. And this top view that we are going to open, and let's click OK. But this looks a bit weird. Let's fix that. This is our camera. Yeah, maybe this works. All right, you can use this like this, or you can turn camera again, and you can use like this. But I prefer this angle. Yeah, there we go. Now, this is a real site plan. Not this. So, in order to use the site plan, we go to this generic axonometric view, right click that, and new 3D document from 3D. And we can name it site plan and click create. It's generating now. And there we have our 3D document. But we are going to change some settings here. So let's right click that and click 3D document settings. For these settings, I want to hide these fields. I want to make them white. So we have cut field here, but we don't have any cut here. Therefore, we go to uncut elements. For the uncut field, not surface, is going to be uniform pan or color field. Let's try this first. And pan color field will be Windows background. Let's click OK. There we go. Now we can see everything. And we have their pan thickness and pan colors. With these settings, you can change their pan colors too. If you want to change them, here we have uniform uncut pans. For the uncut line pen, we can use a solid black and click OK. Now all of them will be black. It's up to you. By the way, we can see the isohips lines because they are mesh, and in the settings, I changed them to show user defined ridges. With that settings, we can see them. Alright, now let's place some dimensions and spot elevations. But before doing that, I suggest you to save this view as site. So I right click here and click save current view and click create. With the view map, now we can see this. And here you can change the name. It's up to you. Now we are in the site plan, and at the left of the window, we have document options here. Let's minimize the design to see all of the document tools. And unfortunately, we cannot use level dimension, but we can use dimensions. Don't get this let you down. We have construction methods here and construction method elevation. Also, we have marker type here. For the spot elevations, we can use this mark, and for its settings, we can use this blank spot. And now it's ready to use. Now we can start to place. But the key point here, we cannot use surface. This type of marker can place on points like this, or here we have point and here we have point. For this point, first we click the point and we move the mouse to surface here, and we can see the circle shows the place the elevation text. As you can see, when I move the mouse around here, a bold line changes its location. For this corner, now the bold lines line show this direction. Now if I place here, and now we get the text. Let's try once more. Let's click the point corner, move the mouse to the surface, and place. Let's try here. Like so. Let's continue. We have a road here. This is the road corner and road elevation. Again, so on. After placing the elevations, you can change its their location also. We have more options: edit length witness line, align dimension line, and insert merge points. But this is spot elevation, so we cannot use them. They're for regular dimensions. If you want to make sure what is the true elevation of this, we can click this point, but we cannot see the real options for this. I'm sorry. Let's go to ground floor. Click that point. Click the elevate mesh point. This is the two mesh reference plane. We need project zero. As you can see, it's minus 200. So our value is true. Let's try this for the roof. I just wonder how it's work. We must see the slab text here. If we try to read this value, we will get something else, because this is the value where the wall starts. So let's delete that, and now we will see the slab. and place here. This is the snap and place. There we go. This is the pool. And we read the snap text. And this is the true value of the pool. Alright guys, this is how you can use dimensions on site plan. I hope you have enjoyed with the tutorial. If so, please hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. If you have any questions or suggestions, please comment in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.